This is the last time I'm going to kneel.
Get up!
You feel.
Get up.
I remember, D.
Or I'll put every person you ever talked to on the fence. I'll blindfold them, and I'll make them eat shit sandwiches for the rest of their short, sorry lives. I'll dig up your dead wife and feed her body to the crows. You feel that? You feel it?
Okay, D. You won. But you know there's nothing left.
Anyways, it was a start. But it wasn't enough. So Dwight, he got the iron. And then I married a super hot wife. Ex-wife. And then after all that, he still got on board. And now look at him. Bow! One of my top guys. And we are totally cool. The point being,
D, we always said that if we got separated, I should come back here and wait for you. You'd show up with beer and pretzels. You remember that? I know. You probably don't. You always said that when we started dating, you forgot to tell me you had a shitty memory. You used to get so frustrated by it, knowing you wouldn't remember those good days. Those special days. I felt bad for you. I remember you said there was so much you wanted to hold on to, and then it'd be gone. But you're lucky you don't remember things, Dee. I wish I could wait for you now. But I don't know if you'd come with me, or if you'd take me back there, or you'd kill me. You didn't want to live in that world, and I made you. I did what I did because I didn't want you to die. But now you've killed, and you've become everything you didn't want to be, and it's my fault. You were better than me. Most people are. I let Daryl go because he reminded you of who you used to be. And I wanted to let you forget. I don't think I'm gonna make it out here. But you're wrong. Being there isn't better than being dead. It's worse. I hope you realize that. I hope you get away. I hope you remember the good days. Even just one of them, but I don't think you will. I don't think you'll ever read this. I loved who you were. I'm sorry I made you into who you are. Goodbye, honey.
What do you make of this, D?
This?
This. Our little road trip.
Opportunity to close. Nothing wrong with that.
Come on, D. Let's wrap here. Let's get candid. Let's get weird. There's nobody here but us chickens. Top guy to top guy. I just want to know if, in your analysis, you believe these people are gonna cower and cave after we deliver what amounts to yet another warning.
Don't get paid to think.
True. Not true. I value your perspective, Dwight. You've been on both sides of the iron. Well, if you're not gonna answer, let me extemporaneously express that I have my doubts this little maneuver is going to deliver the desired outcome.
You think we should do it different?
No. No, no. Not at all. It's a big man's plan. We'll get it done. No question. We've thrown a lot, Rick. Widow, the king, and they just keep coming. Keep fighting. You've seen it. I've seen it. Tallying it up, I keep seeing the same answer. They don't scare.
I do. And I'll help you finish this thing with Rick. Don't sell yourself short, D. You already have. Dwight. Yeah, I see. I found it on the side of the road. Laura, why don't you tell Dee what you told me?
That night in Alexandria, he turned on us. He killed our team. I ran, and I kept on running. I was hurt. But what kept me alive was the thought of getting back here and exposing you for the scum weasel you are.
Makes sense now. You told Rick when to attack. How to get to the outpost. You help keep us locked in here, slipping them workers' guns. I mean, maybe you even lied to me about killing Sherry. Oh, hell, you for sure lied to me about that. So what? You think you're some sort of a hero? No. You are nothing. A nobody in way over your head. But when I said that you would come through for me when I needed it, oh, I meant that 110%. See, I knew that I could count on you to deliver my plan to Rick. My brilliant, if I do say so myself, fake-ass plan. You use Gregory for that, right? I mean, I was thinking maybe you'd take some kind of field trip or something, but no, you got yourself a little delivery boy. Good for you. To deliver all that intel to Rick and the Piss Patrol that's gonna lead them directly into the line of fire. They are not gonna know what hit them. All thanks to my new right-hand man. Now see, I thought about killing you, and then I thought maybe that'd be too dignified for a backstabbing, double-crossing dirtbag such as yourself. No, Dwighty boy. I got plans for you.
That you guys aren't even trying because you're strong and you're smart and you're both really good people, and if you don't wake up and face your...
I got to see Negan taken down, and that's enough. Me. I'm a piece of shit. There's no going back to how things were. I'm sorry. Look, I'm so sorry. Please. Please.
Shut up. You go, and you keep going. Don't you ever come back here again. If I ever see your face around here again, I'll kill you. You make it right.
Find her.